Hello and welcome to the channel. This task has one of the most incredible solutions I've ever seen. It comes from the 18th All-Union Mathematical Olympiad that took place in 1984 in the city of Ashgabat, then the capital of Turkmenian Republic in the Soviet Union. The current spelling and pronunciation is Ashgabat, and the city is the capital of independent country Turkmenistan. When I first looked at the problem, one thing really surprised me. Value YZ appearing in the target expression is found nowhere in the equations. And there doesn't seem to be a way to find the value of YZ other than solving the system of equations. However, we are not asked to solve the system. And I can tell you a secret. The task can be accomplished without solving the system of equations and even without knowing the value of YZ. Another thing I've noticed, and you probably noticed as well, the numbers in the right-hand side are not just full squares. They are the squares of 3, 4, and 5, forming well-known Egyptian triangle. Of course, it could be a mere coincidence, but in this case, it isn't coincidental. And you shouldn't forget that X, Y, and Z are all positive. You've got some hints, so please pause the video and try solving the equation on your own. And here is the solution. For brevity, let D be the value we are after. Take point O somewhere on the plane and construct segment OB with the length of y over square root of 3, followed by segment OC perpendicular to segment OB with length Z. Next, we draw segment OA with length X, forming 120 degrees angle with segment OC. The remaining angle AOB equals 360 degrees minus 120 degrees minus 90 degrees, which gives 150 degrees. However, our problem is purely algebraic. Can I figure out how this geometric drawing can help in solving it? Let's draw triangle ABC and name its sides A small, B small, and C small as shown on the drawing. Side A can be found from triangle BCO using Pythagoras' theorem. A squared equals y over square root of 3 squared plus z squared. After simplification, we get exactly the left-hand side of the second equation of the system, which according to the equation equals 9. Therefore, a squared equals 9 and a equals 3. The value of side B can be found from triangle AOC using cosine rule. B squared equals z squared plus x squared minus 2zx times cosine of 120 degrees. Cosine of 120 degrees is equal to negative cosine of the angle complementing it to 180 degrees. 180 minus 120 is 60, so we change minus to plus and replace cosine of 120 degrees with cosine of 60 degrees. But cosine of 60 degrees is a half. So we end up with the expression matching the left-hand side of the third equation of the system. Therefore, b squared equals 16 and b equals 4. You have certainly guessed what we are going to get for the value of c, but we must observe the formality. So we consider triangle AOB and again use the cosine rule. C squared equals x squared plus y over square root of 3 squared minus 2 times x times y over square root of 3 times cosine of 150 degrees. The complementing angle for 150 degrees is 30 degrees. So we simplify the expression, change minus to plus, and replace cosine of 150 degrees with cosine of 30 degrees. Cosine of 30 degrees is square root of 3 over 2. You cannot imagine anything better than that, because the square roots are cancelled out and 2s are cancelled out as well. So we get a quite cute expression, which, as we all expected, matches the left hand side of the first equation of the system. Therefore, c squared equals 25 and c equals 5. Now we know that the sides of triangle ABC have lengths 3, 4 and 5. This makes ABC an Egyptian triangle. And Egyptian triangle is a right-angled triangle. So angle C is a right angle. And you have a last chance to complete the task on your own. Let A capital be the area of triangle ABC. Since ABC is a right-angled triangle, its area is just half product of its legs. A capital equals half of A times B. Substituting the values of A and B, we find that the area of triangle equals 6. At the same time, the area of triangle ABC can be found as the sum of areas of three already familiar triangles: triangle BCO, triangle AOC, and triangle AOB. And each of these three areas can be expressed in terms of x, y, and z. Triangle BCO is a right-angled triangle, so its area is half times y over square root of 3 times z. And we need to add the area of triangle AOC, which is half of zx times sine of 120 degrees. Finally, we add the area of triangle AOB, half of x times y over square root of 3 times sine of 150 degrees. Next, we simplify the expressions and change each sign with the sine of an angle complementing to 180 degrees. This time, the signs don't change, as sine of any positive angle less than 180 degrees is positive. Sine of 60 degrees is square root of 3 over 2. No cancellation this time. Moreover, there is a concern that two other terms have square root of 3 in the denominator, while this term is not going to have it. So let's get our wish come true, multiplying the numerator and denominator by square root of 3. We get 3 over 2 times square root of 3, and this value will be used as the sine of 60 degrees. The sine of 30 degrees is just a half. This shouldn't cause any problem at all. And we substitute the values for the sines. Now we factor out 1 over 4 square root of 3 and get in the brackets what we secretly hoped to get. Indeed, this is precisely d, the value we are aiming for. So we write a equals d divided by 4 square root of 3. Therefore, d equals 4a times square root of 3. But the value of a is known, it is 6. Therefore, d is 24 square root of 3. This is the answer. And the end. It was really enjoyable for me, and hopefully for you too.